We can check this out. This looks pretty good. It's the legendary power of Lennox Lewis.
As the years pass, more and more boxing fans are starting to agree that the 90s heavyweight division was perhaps the most talent-rich and physically capable era in history.
These are awesome punches. Boxing at that time is just crazy.
Yet amongst the array of beasts, one man emerged
but he's right,
from start
especially
to finish
heavyweight.
As the finest boxer of them all, the only fighter of his time that defeated every foe he faced, the pugilist specialist, Lennox Lewis.
The pride of Great Britain.
Let that shit go!
Left hook by Lewis! Galana goes down!
Welcome back to Greatest Hits here on Boxing Legends TV.
That man was stunned.
On this series, we
shocked.
Recap an iconic career from the past using VHS tapes that were digitally enhanced and upscaled to recapture that feeling of watching great fights from the 90s on CRT televisions. We certainly appreciated the feedback on our Tommy Morrison piece a couple of months ago, and ever since, we've been working hard to produce a video for a man whose career undoubtedly ranks amongst the top five in the division's history.
And
a resume stacked with brutal
VHS
knockouts
footage.
And historical battles.
Very cool.
Here now, BLTV presents Lennox Lewis's Greatest Hits.
Lennox Lewis is the best. I laid them all to rest.
That's it.
July 12, 1991. After establishing himself as the number one contender in Europe, Lennox ventured to the States to start building a resume worthy of international respect.
Here we go. Round one scheduled for 10. And Weaver comes right at Lewis. Weaver said he doesn't want to box him. He's just too big for that.
Oh,
the right hand from Lewis. Crowd getting a little bit restless here as they see more of the same now.
The crowd started to get on the young Brit's back, and in response, Lennox unleashed his first big right hand of the night.
Oh, and Weaver's down. The right hand from Lennox Lewis. A stunning sixth round knockout.
That'll get the attention.
I never got suckered into that. I took my time until he exposed himself, and then he exposed himself, and I ended it.
For the first and last time of his entire career, Lennox entered the ring as a significant underdog when he met the murderous punching Canadian, Donovan Razor Ruddock.
Oh, there's actually this guy. I forgot his first name.
Ruddock made it back to his feet, but was quickly put to rest by a man determined to get the job done as quickly as possible. A huge statement, but nothing that surprised Lennox, as he explained in his post-fight interview.
Watching hours of tape on Razor Ruddock, I realized
straight
that
laid him down.
His left hand low, and
he didn't really get to like fight with his legs back. You know, like get to fight back up. Like both times he went down, he just straight got laid down.
But nothing that surprised
that power
Lennox,
was strong.
As he explained in his post-fight interview.
Watching hours of tape on Razor Ruddock, I realized that he kept his left hand low, and I just took advantage of that. He's never been in with a fast heavyweight that throws a natural right hand like myself.
Hollywood stars were in the building.
Tom
as Lennox Lewis looked to certify his recent position as the WBC champion after being handed the belt due to political issues.
The chess match ensues.
Solid right.
Doesn't get mad at 6'5". They will nullify.
A perfectly timed right hand sent Tucker crashing to the canvas for the first time in his career. However, the former champ responded well, as in the eighth, Lennox absorbed more punishment than in all of his previous fights combined.
Cody Tucker to the head of Lewis, and Lewis just standing there!
The two slugged it out to the finish, where Lennox earned a unanimous decision in what was an excellent fight to build upon his already feared reputation.
I give Tony Tucker enough respect because he's got a great chin, he's got guts. If that was Riddick Bowe would have been down on the ground. But Tony Tucker, he realized that this was his last chance and I have to do more to cut it in the rough.
5 months later, Lennox was back in the UK to settle a score with the much in form and darling of the nation, Frank Bruno.
You lose your vision with Lennox Lewis, you're going to get knocked out.
Due to his core British roots, Bruno was the crowd favorite, which was evident as they went crazy for every punch he landed.
Appeared against Williams.
Good right hand by Bruno.
Oh, hey, what happened? Gizmo, you alright? What happened? Man, like...
His roots, Bruno was the crowd favorite, which was evident as they went crazy for every punch he landed.
The cut appeared against Williams. Bruno has Lewis in serious trouble. Let's see if Lennox knows how to hold on.
Straight on.
Over the first four rounds, Bruno boxed an immaculate fight, testing Lennox's chin to the best of his ability.
Bruno pounding his fists together to jack himself up. Sometimes a double jam.
Gonna waste a few times. That hurts him more now.
Lennox remained unfazed by Bruno's spirited effort, as once the big man started gassing, he was forced to continue at Lennox's relentless pace, leaving huge gaps in his defense to exploit.
What a comeback by Lewis! It was a left hook that turned this around. A frozen Frank Bruno is there taking punishment. And Mickey Van is going to stop it.
Bruno had a great chin and probably could have absorbed a dozen or more of those big bombs without going down. Mickey Van did the right thing by stopping
the man
course,
just had him
and
up
Lewis
on the ropes,
gained a huge chunk of fans
him.
That he had been so desperate to have on board.
Damn. Fought back hard.
Another big night of world championship boxing took place on October 7, 1995, as the former world champion Tommy Morrison, now sporting a more mature look, tried to restore his position as the number one contender.
I think it will be a little leery of my power.
Oh, is this...
Everybody is. So.
Wait, is this the Morrison-Lennox fight?
Position as the number one contender.
I think it will be a little leery of my power. Everybody is. So I don't think I have physically, I have the skill to outbox him. I got to fight my fight. It's simple. I fight my fight, I win.
Lennox's reputation around the division was made pretty clear there by Morrison, interestingly claiming he couldn't compete with him in a pure boxing match.
Since the McCall fight. Hard right hand by Tommy Morrison. I can tell you one more thing. With those right hands as he steps inside.
You gotta make it happen, Tommy. You're high on me. You're high on me. I need you lower.
To his credit, Morrison boxed well and threw some troubling shots for three rounds. After weathering yet another early storm, Lennox started piecing up Tommy with
Lennox
crisp jabs and overhand
like
rights,
really
inflicting heavy damage upon his right eye.
Now he comes back to the jab. Say to the doctor, I've still got my left hook getting very close to a stoppage here. You get that sense. Down goes Morrison again, and I wonder if Mills has seen enough. That'll do it.
A terrific performance by
that left hook. We've gotten two of them with it. Maybe three.
Another excellent matchup was made for Lennox in 1996, as anything short of war with merciless Ray Mercer wouldn't have sat well with Bane.
But he can take another step toward public acceptance here.
Hard to get in.
Good combination by Lewis.
Straight to the throat.
Mercer momentarily stunned.
War is what they wanted, and war is what they got. The fight had no narrative, no ups and downs. Both men just bludgeoned each other over the scheduled 10 rounds.
Both men landed.
For the winner on a split decision, Lennox!
A split decision was awarded to the right man, with the cleaner
yeah,
work and eye-catching combos
like
from Lewis
fight.
Being the overriding factor in what was an even contest as a whole.
Because I hit him with some shots and I felt it in my hand.
What are those shades? So tiny on him. I look cool.
I felt it in my hand, and he kept coming.
little red shades.
After suffering his first pro defeat, Lennox hired the man that orchestrated his loss and brought on board the legendary coach Emmanuel Stewart to help him utilize his skills to their full potential.
Effectively followed the fight plan. Hard right hand by Lewis.
Daniel's trying to.
Kind of stamina McCall has.
Lennox was punching hard and fast, but even more devastatingly so, extremely accurate. McCall started acting up to the crowd, taunting Lewis. Nothing out of the ordinary
like
for a fighter getting schooled. But then things took a bizarre turn. McCall started walking around the ring during the intervals and appeared to be crying for reasons no one could quite understand. The madness continued as they resumed, where McCall, seen here walking with his back turned to Lewis, left no choice for the ref.
Man probably didn't want
to
fight anymore.
The safety of a man that was reluctant to defend himself.
Well, I've seen some strange things in boxing. That is surely one of the strangest.
McCall's problems lie deeper than expected, as he was later sectioned under the Mental Health Act.
And, you know, when he started walking away, I thought it was a joke at first. I thought he was trying to know me into something.
Oh, that is so strange.
After Andrew Galata had proven his boxing ability against Riddick Bowe, he entered the ring with Lewis even money and was being viewed as a live dog that could outbox Lennox as and if the rounds progressed.
Galata a little bit more tentative at the outset.
out into center ring. Right hand over the top by Lewis. Galata momentarily stunned. Left hook by Lewis. Galata goes down.
Oh, that was the guy in the beginning. No wonder he looks so shocked. I mean, the man was all up on his case as soon as the bell rang.
Galata a little bit more tentative at the outset.
Pretty much like 30 seconds in, he's just all up on
it. Back out into center ring. Right hand over the
left again.
Galata momentarily stunned. Left hook by Lewis. Galata goes down. That's it.
A brutal display of dominance, leaving
right
egg
there
on the face of all the experts that quite obviously underestimated how far Lennox ranked above lingering contenders.
And I basically wanted to go out there and hit him before he could commit any fouls in there. Once I had him hurt, just take him out.
Oh, and he catches
Lewis versus Shannon Briggs.
And Briggs jumps all over him.
Let's go, champ. Let's go, champ.
Briggs,
I know this guy.
Briggs, a fearsome fast starter that to this day holds the record for the most first-round knockouts at heavyweight, came out bombing
Holy.
Lewis all over the place and had the Brit
Here's
hanging
Shannon.
On for safety for large
Holy,
points during the opening
left.
6 minutes.
Briggs now, fighting in spots, picked a good one here.
Shannon's body seized up, however, from overexerting himself soon after, which allowed Lennox to take over and start breaking his man down.
It's a lazy jab. Lennox sees something now. He's a different confidence about him. He sees something in Shannon Briggs to go after. And I agree. I think the timing is right by Lennox. Good combination from the champ. Oh, he's just playing with him now. The champ's just playing with him.
He's straight smiling at him.
Lewis is completely confident right now.
Let's go, champ.
Nice jab, right.
Oh,
the right hand behind the jab.
Come on, champ.
He's laid out. He is laid out just staring at the ceiling here at Boardwalk Hall.
Damn, that was a nasty right. Jeez. Holyfield.
Lennox had another chance to right a wrong.
Man, he's fought a lot of big names. Some that I haven't even seen fight, but I actually do know. But like a lot of these are huge names. Goliath, man.
13th, 1999.
Heavyweight boxing.
Rematching
and boxing in general
is
so much.
After a scandalous draw a few months prior.
So many big characters. Good fighters.
Well, his gloves have come down a bit. He's hit by a right hand. This time. That's a big left hook from Lennox Lewis this time. Seventh round here. Look at this now. Tremendous action. This is how good boxing can be.
Both fighters were ranked 1 and 2 by the Ring magazine, respectively, which, after 8 or 9 excellent rounds, seemed fair as both guys were evenly matched. The championship rounds became the deciding factor as Lennox squeezed out every bit of effort, throwing combinations off sheer instinct to the final bell.
Lennox Lewis!
As Lennox performed his pre-fight war dance, his opponent, the undefeated American giant Michael Grant, seemed taken back by Lewis's calm demeanor.
Early thunder from Grant. Lewis tries to fire back. Grant said he would come out aggressively.
They're just firing away. Jeez. Man walking around with his mouth open. Yo, that is dangerous. Chio.
While he didn't, in fact, break his legs as George Foreman suggested, he did shatter his heart, and Lennox essentially put to rest America's last hope of heavyweight supremacy through a prospect.
So I realized I got more superior speed. He's never seen a boxer like me, so I felt very confident going in there.
As he should. Confidence is key.
By Lennox Lewis with the right hand. He hit by the right hand. And I'll tell you, Lennox built the part. Nice right hand. Sport in the UK. This is a dandy of a heavyweight title fight. Lennox has that jab in the base. Big clips him with the left hook.
Outside of the odd leaping hook such as this, Tua was thoroughly outclassed as Lennox proceeded to tee up big right hands at will. The Samoan's chin ended up being the only skill worthy of praise.
Digging body shot. That's what he gets. Oh, the right
hand. Man hasn't gone down yet.
It's in this sort of fight.
Lennox round 11 still up. Back to round 9.
Right now, Lennox Lewis is giving an old-fashioned whooping to David Tua.
Couldn't put him away, but it,
after
you know,
suffering
pretty
a
much
shock defeat to Haseeb Rahman in South Africa, Lennox wasted no time getting his American opponent back in the ring after what he felt was nothing more than a lucky punch.
You know, he's dealing with disrespect, so I have to show him that I'm not taking it.
I had to just give Lennox Lewis a preview of what he's going to get on November 17th, put him on his back.
They used an excuse of a few idiotic comments to get hands-on with each other before the fight, yet there was nothing said other than throwaway words. These two just hated each other, and Lennox channeled that anger to devastating effect.
He used that, that's very important. He's really throwing the punch with authority. So that he... The jab alone. There's that right hand, which has been a honey punch for him down the years.
He's going to get his jab for power.
Oh!
Wonderful shot by Lennox Lewis, and he's laid out.
That's it. That's it, no?
Considered goodness. By many as one of the greatest knockouts in boxing history, certainly the sweetest revenge.
Yeah, he did. Those things really helped me. You know, I showed a lot of disrespect there, and I just
was
keeping all these
right
things
on
inside
the
me.
Chin.
I said, okay, you're
gonna. Huh? Oh, man. Muted. On the Tyson one. Of course. That makes sense. Should we make our own music? Put our own music? There we go. I'm gonna shoot they baby mama. Oh, I got the pole. Oh, hey, what were them boys got handguns? Handguns? Your friends can't trust them. Oh, stop chasing. Spit the truth on the verse. If they paid you to do it, you don't gotta ask what you worth. Me and Savage, we came from the dirt. If you rapping for money, you silly. This shit ain't a million. Look at Mike out there looking like a monster. I think it's one of the few Mike Tyson fights I've never seen. Nope. What else? Here we go. Next round. Oh. 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 Jesus, bruh. Good lord. That was the one. Jesus.
Oh. And he can take a hell of a punch because I hit him with some great punches, and boy, he can take him for real.
In what was supposed to have been a routine retirement fight against Kirk Johnson, it turned into a significant battle of the ages as the then relatively unknown
Klitschko.
Ukrainian giant Vitaly Klitschko, who we now consider the best heavyweight of the 2000s, stepped in as a late replacement.
He is a long reigning champ. Hotel,
California.
For sure.
So will it be heaven or will it be hell? Klitschko with the right, Lewis misses with the left. Hard right hand by Klitschko, best punch of the round.
He's got a different.
Left hand lands for Klitschko. Awkward short arm shots. He's beating Lewis to the punch. Vitaly Klitschko is roughing Lennox Lewis up as the second round begins to come down the stretch.
Vitaly shocked everyone by taking the fight directly to Lewis instead of engaging in a battle of the jabs as many thought he would. The assault never slowed down. Only Lennox, after a couple of tough rounds, was able to wake up and finally start competing with his determined opponent
Cut
on a level playing
field,
which led to an incredibly rare
slugfest
between the two 6'6+ giants.
Staying away from that big old
every time the Lennox moves, he gets
up. And the way he's throwing punches.
Oh, that looked like it was gonna be a good right. No. It looked like he straight was about to blast it.
But Lewis beginning to
man.
Up his punches and landing at a higher and higher rate.
No cut man in the world could have cleaned up this mess, and it led to the ref, to this clear dismay of Vitaly, calling a halt to the action.
On his
Many
eye?
People think Lennox got fortunate here, and it's easy to see why. But if you look back on all the fights we presented today, show me one time where his conditioning and boxing skill didn't result in him eventually taking over and becoming the ring general.
Tremendous fight for six rounds.
Yeah, I want it to be in a dogfight, because I know when the going gets tough, the tough get going. I'm tougher than him.
Unlike all the heavyweights out there, he has never ducked an opponent.
Man's a beast when it comes to boxing. You know, we've got his pictures all up in my gym.
Again.
He's a good fighter. He make great fight.
I guess it was on his eye.
But the only big fighter old cut out there that I've always looked at and just thought, I don't know what I would have done, is Lennox Lewis.
The double jab.
Gonna waste a few times.
I've always said from the day that I first saw Lennox, he was the best heavyweight that I ever saw.
And a great right uppercut by Lewis.
Hats off to Lennox Lewis. He took some of the best shots I had to give.
Left hook by Lewis.
He's a long arm guy. I have no excuses. I mean, he was the better man tonight.
Nice jet right.
Oh,
the right. Oh, no, come on, champ. Not like this, champ.
It seemed like everything started happening to me. He was just, he bust me eardrum.
He's very good.
Why is he good?
He's big. He's strong. He has, you know, classy moves. He's a good fighter.
Probably one of the greatest, if not the greatest. He didn't beat everybody.
To get his jab for power.
Oh! Wonderful shot by
Lennox
Lewis!
Probably the best one, honestly.
But I'd have known deep down.
The Mike Tyson one was shocking, but that one was clean.
It's not going to go that well for you.
Well, that was good.